We are for round 5 of this league with this crazy Temur deck with black. On the draw this, or no, I guess I am on the play. I didn't even realize. It's 5 for 5 in die rolls, so certainly running good. This hand's pretty solid. It's a little awkward in the fact that it's going to be hard to get a black source. I'm not going to be able to get a black source by turn 4 and cast both of these on curve. I'm going to have to take one turn to play a tap land instead of one of these guys. So I think I'm going to play this next turn, and then by waiting a turn to play a tap land as well, I also get to play Woodland Wanderer with Stubborn Denial up. So I think that's just going to be my plan here. Mirror's Cut. I definitely want to get a black source at some point now. And I think this is going to be a mountain. Yeah. So in this next turn, I think I'm going to play Wooded Foothills and then sack it to get a black duel, black-red. So this will get a black-red duel. And then if I draw another untapped land, I can actually play this. But I still think I might want to wait. If he's playing like Jeskai or Esper, which is obviously very likely after he started on Sunken Hollow. He could be playing Abzan. Even if he's playing Abzan, you know, all those decks have cheap removal, so I'm probably just going to wait to play this on turn 5 anyways. Unless I draw, like, you know, on turn 3 I draw an untapped land, then on turn 4 I draw another 4-drop, then I'll just jam. Jace, huh? There's an untapped land. Okay, so I'm still going to go ahead and... Now I kind of want to get this in play, because I can always sack this to get a swamp if I want to play this. And then if I don't play this... Well, because on turn 5... I don't want to wait till turn 5 to play this. Or sorry. I don't want to wait till turn 5 to play this, because I'm going to want to play a 4-drop and leave up Stubborn Denial. So yeah, I definitely want to play Lumbering Falls right now. Yeah, it worked out because this can get us in just a swamp. If I had drawn, like, you know, another Wooded Foothills or a Bloodstained Mire, I guess Bloodstained Mire gets swamped too. So if I would have drawn another Wooded Foothills, I would have had to play Foothills instead of Lumbering Falls that turn. Yeah, I think next turn, if he just, well, it depends what he does here. Roast. Okay, I guess I've seen a few of those main deck. I definitely want to not cast Woodland Wonder next turn, though. I want to wait until I can Stubborn it out like a Crackling Doom. And this turn, I'm almost certainly going to just Murderous Cut that. It'd be nice if I draw a 2-drop so I can, like, another Snapping Gnarled, so I can play Snapping Gnarled and Murderous Cut that. So Tasker would be good, too. Oh, so he's, like, he's not Jeskai. He's, like, some Grixis deck. Interesting. Well, that makes me want to just play that, but I think I'm still going to just Murderous Cut that, because he can flip that if I wait. Well, it is immune to Roast. I mean, he'd have to have another fetch or any spell to flip it, which I think is likely, so I'm just going to go ahead and Murderous Cut that now. I don't think I want to leave up Stubborn Denial. Yeah, I think it just makes it too obvious what I have. And I don't think there's... If he was, like, playing white... No, I guess technically he could still, like, sack this, get a Prairie Stream. But if I thought I might have to counterspell a Gideon, then I would. But I don't think there's really anything too crazy that I'm going to want to counterspell here. Gonna counterspell me dispel, I guess. Oh, he has his own Stubborn Denials. Well, That's certainly something I wish I could have stubborn denied, so I guess maybe I fucked up. I still think I would rather use my Stubborn Denial to save my Woodland Wanderer, because I can kill that after one attack. Because he, like, has to use a removal spell to kill my Wanderer, and I Stubborn Denial it. And then, I guess he can plus Jace on my Wanderer, so I can only hit it for 4. And then Jace is on 3, so he can flashback his spell. And that's not ideal. I have to sack this now, because this can't get Blue Source. So I'm going to get Cinder Glade, I guess. I have double red. I need... This way I have green and blue to activate Lumbering Falls. If I need to. Oh, I guess I can activate Lumbering Falls next turn to kill his Jace. Okay. I mean, it's unfortunate if he has a counterspell for this, because then I have to Stubborn Denial the counterspell. I guess I couldn't even do that because I wouldn't have Ferocious, so luckily he didn't have anything. I was thinking last turn when I thought he still might be Jeskai, I was thinking his counterspell would be Odutai's Command, so that's why I was thinking I could Stubborn Denial it. But so what do we have here? Is it a Falting Invocation? Yeah, I'm definitely going to Stubborn Denial that. So he must be some... Okay, down here, revealed a Dragonlord Silengar. That's not good for me at all. Probably can't beat that card. So there's flashing back Faltung. Originally when I was thinking he would have a removal spell, he would have to wait till his turn, because I didn't think he was a dragon deck with Omnixilis, but so I thought he'd have to like cast like, you know, Ruinous Path or something. But as is, he can just flash it back right now. So I was thinking I'd get to attack Jace. I mean, I can still attack and kill Jace, which is probably what I'm going to do, rather than just play this. So if I just play this, he can steal it with his Silengar. Ooh, that was a great draw. I definitely don't want to play that, because he can steal it with Silengar. I forgot it can steal Planeswalkers too, so... But if I draw some way to deal with Silengar, geez, Silengar is really good against this deck. Dragonlord Silengar is really good against this deck, because I don't have any like instant speed removal for it. You know, my only way to kill it is with Crater's Claws. I guess post-board I'm going to have Transgress the Mind and Disdainful Stroke, but we didn't have a land. I could just try to kill him before he draws a land. I mean, it's unlikely that he just has nothing, though. If he has Faltung, both animating this and attacking with this is terrible. So I play this, and he does have he just lands Silengar. He steals it, attacks me, I play this, and he still just attack me again. Then I attack with this, and if he trades with Silengar, I get my Sarkhan back. That doesn't seem good. Alright, well, I'm thinking my plan is just to hope that he does not draw another land. Or have any spells. So I don't know what all the spells could be, but I guess if he's going to draw spells, spell that does something, I hope it's Jace, and then I can minus this to kill Jace. You have another Faltung. Yeah. That is very bad for me. I mean, now I'm just going to keep attacking with this. Like, I just can't cast a spell until I draw Crater's Claws. So I'll fetch this. Alright, I'll just jam. Because if he taps out for his thing, then I just get a play. I just get a Crater's Closet, which is fine. Might as well just counterspell this. Then I'm back to just attacking him with Lumbering Falls until I get him into Crater's Claws range. So I'm going to have to use all of my mana. I hope I draw Tassigar. That would be a great draw. So I can play Tassigar, play this for 4 mana. I guess I can't do much else, but Gnarled, that's not a great draw. 6. Okay, at least got 4 cards in hand, and none of them, or at least 3 are not lands. So that certainly does not bode well for me. But I've been in worse spots. I do have a lot of pressure. If somehow his spells just do nothing, he's going to die next turn. Right? I draw land. 9, 10, 11. Or I draw fetch land. Ooh, maybe I should cast that because he could have the Awaken counterspell. Okay, just Silumgar Scorn. No land, or no dragon. Yeah, it's a little awkward that I... Well, I mean, if I did a pre-combat, I think I'd rather attack for 3 anyways there. Jace, that's great. I needed him to draw something exactly like that. Even if he has a counterspell, I drew another one. It's probably not good because it's very unlikely that I'll use this other one, but... as a backup just in case. Wow, he's actually just like dead next turn if he doesn't have anything. That's kind of crazy. I thought we were so far behind this game. Jace. Alright. I guess I'll Fiery Impulse that in case he has a removal spell for this. He can't jump block my Lumbering Falls. Wow. I'm very surprised I won that game. I can't imagine what his hand must have been. It must have been just more Silumgar Scorns. And, I don't know, other weird stuff. Dress has got to be great, Stubborn Owl's great, Dispel, Disdainful Stroke. This doesn't hit Silumgar, right? Just Ojutai. He didn't even have white in his deck, so... Grixis Dragons. Transgress definitely coming in. Board out all of these. I think Crater's Claws is bad. Like, it was obviously great that game. I guess we should have Murderous Cuts, too. I'm not used to my Temur deck having real removal, so I said we didn't have any instant removal. That's just a straight lie. So I don't think Silumgar is that bad for us, actually. I haven't cut 2 Crater's Claws. It's like very bad against counter spells, and we just have Murder's Cut for Silumgar anyways. So this hand is very good if I draw another land, but. I don't think I'm going to keep. This can't even get green anyways, so definitely going to mulligan. Okay, this hand's actually not that bad. Oh, now it's pretty good, I think. Lumbering Falls is very good in this matchup. I guess he has Foul Tongue, so it's not as good as it is against normal Esper. Esper not dragons, I guess. But, still solid. Also, if he duresses me, it's going to be great. I imagine he would board and duress if he has them, because I have Stubborn Owls and stuff. Jace is pretty good against this hand, though. I'm just going to play Gnarled, just more pressure. Wait, so he also had Stubborn Denial. That was really weird. So he must have, like, Tassigars. Because, and even that he's, I would imagine he has something else besides Tassigar, too, because that seems pretty loose to have... that just with Tassigar. Maybe he has like Culligan or something? He probably has Culligan. I just want to play my tap land here. So if I fetch this turn, play Rattleclaw. But even if I play tap land and play Rattleclaw, I can still fetch and play Tassigar next turn. So yeah. Very likely to flip Jace this turn. It's kind of annoying, but not much I can do about it. That's very annoying. I was going to say, if you spaz a removal spell, and if you can flip and then recast Roast, that would be no bueno. Well, that sucks. Well, I guess this turn I'm just going to cast Tasigur, so it's okay. I mean, he had to tap out to do it, so... I mean, Tasigur is fairly I guess it gets roasted, but hopefully he doesn't have another one. I'm not going to have a red source that I can play untapped next turn, but... hopefully it won't matter. I mean, it's definitely right to jam Tasigur here. I don't think I want to get either of these guys back with my Tasker's ability. I think I'd rather just, if you know the game goes that long, if it lives, I'd rather just hit stuff like Dispel and Stubborn Denial, Disdainful Stroke, or my other big threats, more Tasker's, etc., etc. Alright, well, I guess I can hit this too. If there's no removal for Tasker, I'm in pretty good shape. Ooh, Stubborn Denial, that was great. Now I'm just gonna... I can't actually do that. I was thinking I would just kill Jace, but I think I'm just gonna attack Jace for two. Like, I mean, I could kill it if I want to animate Lumbering Falls, so I certainly would do had I not drawn Stubborn Denial, but... Stubborn Denial is a pretty good draw. I mean, it's actually not Counterspell right now, because he plus Jace. So... if he casts a spell, hopefully he does it before he pluses Jace. Wait, did I misclick or something? Yeah, he definitely took two. Huh. That's unfortunate. I 100% meant to attack Jace. Now I really hope I draw an untap land so I can kill Jace. God, that's gross. Also, if he kills Tasigur now, I can't kill Jace. At least he's tapping out, so if it's a spell, I can kill it. Nope, Kulgan. Is it dashed? That would be very lucky for me. Nope, just cast. Alright. Well, I hope I draw a Murderous Cut. Man, I really wish this Jace was at 2. So I could animate my Lumbering Falls and attack Jace, but that seems very bad because he just blocks Lumbering Falls and Jace goes to 2. I think I'm still going to attack Jace for 2. It's kind of free and I could play like, I don't know. I don't know what card I could have that would make him not block, but there's no reason not to. Actually, I think I'm going to activate Tasigur instead of playing this guy. Yeah. I don't love it, but... I guess I could have played this and activated Tasigur with, and just not had Stubborn Denial up. That was probably the right play. Stubborn Denial is really not doing much when this if this keeps getting shrunk, so... Omnix List, nice. I lied. It's great. I could have activated this on the that on the stack. Yeah, that was definitely right. Just got all the Rattleclaw Mystics. Guess I'll go ahead and morph it. I can't bluff a Stubborn Denial, but I guess that's okay. Destroy all non-dragon creatures. Well, that's pretty good. These all come to play untapped, right? So I'm just gonna... McClain. I'm gonna flip this, and then if I hit two lands, he like basically has to give me Savage Knuckleblade, which is pretty good right now. No, I guess he can give me Dispel. That doesn't counter Crux. Never mind. Still though, it forces him to give me, like, you know, Dispel is pretty good, I think. Otherwise, like, I think it's much better than Stubborn Denial, because if I don't flip this and just do that, he can just give me Stubborn Denial and then I have nothing. But also there's just no reason not to flip it since it's just dying. He could attack me for 5 here and I get to attack his Jace. I guess that's probably good for him. That was not great for me. I think I just want to cast it face up just so I can leave up Dispel. This can't get blue since I already have blue-black in play, so I'll fetch it now. Attack me for 5 again. I hope I draw, like, Sarkhan. Sarkhan would be great. Actually, it wouldn't be that great, because he would just kill it on the... He would just attack me back. Draw, like, Murderous Cut, would that be good? It would be okay. Murderous Cut would be fairly solid. It would just take away all his pressure, and then I could grind him out with these Lumbering Falls. Bloodstained Mire's not going to do... anything good. I could attack with both. I think that's what I'm going to do. I have to, you know, tap out, but don't really have that many options, I think. Oh, wait, then I just die, because Jace can attack, can it? Yeah, so I can just attack him with both of these, and I take... Oh, no, it's only 6. Oh, yeah, but I fetch, so... Okay, well, that makes that decision easy, I guess. Maybe I do want Crater's Claws. It just is another answer to his other dragons too. I think I'm gonna bring in one or maybe both of them that I boarded out for this next game. Dragon Lord Silumgar. Alright, well, I'm super dead. I guess I could draw Crater's Claws. Is that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9? No, I can't even fetch twice anyways, so. Okay, let's see. It's green or white, that's obviously bad. I do like most of the cards I'm playing, though. Could maybe cut, like, one of these Stubborn Denials. It's a little awkward against Jace, but it's still fine. Maybe one of these Woodland Wanderers. No, I like that too. It's a giant creature, gets through his dragons. Like a Snapping Gnarled between his dragons and Cruxes. But I feel like I just want to be aggressive. Maybe Rattleclaw. Yeah, I think I'm going to cut Rattleclaw for the Crater's Claws. Dice of Wrath doesn't actually attack through anything. It like helps me cast my like 4-drop with Stubborn Denial up early, but I don't think it's important to be that fast in this matchup. Okay, this hand's pretty great. Let's see, and I can even fetch a blue-black tap land, and then fetch a untap land, transgress him, and then play that on turn 3, so perfect. This is probably going to get a mountain, I guess, yeah. don't change anything. Okay, so he just has Jace. Take that. I could just Creator's Claws the Jace here. I think I'm going to do that. Because the next turn I can just play and haste my Knuckleblade. Or no, actually I won't be able to because I won't be able to get double red. Okay, so never mind. I'm just going to jam Knuckleblade here. Right, because this... Yeah, none of my battle lands come into play untapped. Let's see. I guess I could have just gotten a swamp with the first one. So this is definitely going to get a black-red duel at some point, because I need double red for that. So this next turn I can just pay one mana to... I mean, hopefully he doesn't draw a removal spell right now. That would be pretty bad for me. He's drawn three cards since I transgressed him. Okay, sweet. That was interesting. I think I'm gonna attack for four and just kill Jace. Because he can't actually counterspell the second Knuckleblade. I could just play Knuckleblade and leave Delta untapped, and then if he casts something that I want a Stubborn Denial, crack it for Island, and if not, crack it for the other thing. I think I just want to kill Jace here, though. It's much cleaner. Then I can for sure get a second red source and leave up this Stubborn Denial. Then he can't, like, Stubborn Denial me back or something. Yeah, X is zero. If I draw a land this turn, I can just Knuckleblade, give it haste, and have Stubborn Denial up. It's nice that these Knuckleblades can attack through a Culligan. It's still going to be awkward against Silumgar. I guess not really, because you'll have to take it and it'll be tapped, and I'll just get one attack through yet. I guess he doesn't have green mana, so he can't, like, trade my Knuckleblade with my other Knuckleblade. Okay, that was good. I think I want to get a forest with this. Yeah, I have to. It's the only other untapped land in my deck that I can get right now. Forest, and then... Knuckleblade. I don't think I'm going to counterspell that. If he has a counterspell here, I don't think I'm going to use my own counterspell. But he's just floating mana. Okay. I definitely want to save my counterspell for a Wrath of God. I guess I'll go to beginning of combat first. Make him use his mana. If I'd be putting him to four, then I would be fine countering his counterspell, because then I can just, you know, countering his dig or whatever, but I'm definitely going to let this dig resolve. But yeah, if he could Wrath and be at 4, then that'd be perfectly fine, because I can just Circuit and kill him, but it's not quite the case. We were victorious. So yeah, there's the Temur deck. Pretty strong, obviously. I'm not sure. There's an SCG open this weekend. I might play this. I still might just play Abzan. I played Abzan a lot more. I know that deck's good. I think this deck is probably good, but I mean, 5-0-1 league doesn't say, you know, that much. But we'll see. You know, see how I might play a little bit more with it and see if it's good enough. But anyways, thanks for watching, and I hope you...